Hi guys, so today I thought I would teach you how to play a mancala game that's really popular in Rwanda and Uganda. So mancala is sort of a broad term, which means any game where you've got holes and you are putting stones or pips into the holes. So the holes can be on a board or they can be in the dirt. Any game where you're placing pips or stones into the holes, that's a mancala game. So this particular type of mancala is called omweso in Uganda, and apparently that is derived from Swahili and it just means game. Here in Rwanda it's called igisoro. I'm not entirely sure what that means, but we do have a saying that if you're going down a really bad mud road and there's massive potholes in that road, it's an igisoro road because it looks like this. So many mancala games that you see will only have two rows. So you're playing around two rows of holes. The igisoro and omweso boards have four rows of two, four, six, eight. Four rows of eight. And we're playing using these little seeds. I don't know how well you can see that. But they're called empiki. And I'm not too sure where they come from. Some people say they're from wild bananas and other people say that they're from a specific tree. If you know, please do drop it below. They remind me a bit of tamarind seeds, but they're not quite. They're just very, very hard, tiny seeds. So I learned to play this in, I think it was about 2008. I went to Kampala, the capital of Uganda, to go to the Amakula Film Festival. And whilst I was there, I decided to visit the Kasubi royal tombs. So those are the historic tombs of the Kabaka, which is the king of Uganda. So here we have a Mwami, the Mwami Palace in Nyanza. So Mwami is the word for king. In Uganda, Lugandan, it's Kabaka. So I went to visit the royal tombs. So whilst I was at Kasubi, my guide, who was showing me around, explained that he was a royal prince of Uganda. And I was sort of, really? A royal African prince, really? Turns out he actually was. And he took me around the House of Parliament. He took me to quite a significant mosque in Kampala, and he taught me how to play omweso, because apparently if you could beat the king of Uganda in a game of omweso, he would give you land. I definitely didn't beat my friend on my attempts, but he taught me the rules of omweso. Now I've not learned the rules of igisoro, but I think they're the same. If I'm wrong, let me know the rules that you use below, because I do know there are quite a few different variations. So without further ado, this is how you play, at least on omweso, possibly also igisoro. Okay, so the first thing that you need to know is which side of the board is yours. So when we're playing, these two rows belong to you, and these two rows closest to me belong to me. So you're only playing in these two rows and I'm only playing in these two rows. So to set up the board, we're going to put four empiki in each of the outside holes. So each of the holes that are closest to you and each of the holes that are closest to me. Okay, so here's where it can start to get a little bit complicated. Different people play by different rules. Some people say that you have to start exactly as the board is laid out. Other people say that you can choose to move sets of four forward. So if you feel like moving four of them forward, you can, but you don't have to. And the version that I prefer is that you can choose combinations. So you can move up to four seeds into the bowl in front. But before you decide how you want to set it out, it's best to understand what the rest of the rules are. So I'm going to be moving around the board in an anti-clockwise direction from left to right. And you're going to be doing the same on your side, going around anti-clockwise from your left to your right. So moving forward is really simple. Choose from any of the holes that have more than one seed in. Pick up all of the seeds in that hole, then place one seed in the next hole and keep going until you have no more seeds left. When you have no more seeds in your hand and only one seed in the hole, that is the end of your turn. But let's say that your final seed lands in a hole that already has a seed in it. If that happens, you pick up all of the seeds in that hole, and then from the next hole, you start laying your seeds one by one. Here, I've landed in a hole that already has a seed in it, so I'm picking up both seeds, and off I go again, until I land in a hole that is empty, and that is the end of my turn. You cannot move a single seed on its own. You can only pick up multiple seeds. And you cannot choose not to pick up multiple seeds. If you land in a hole that is occupied, you must play the seeds in that hole. So the aim of the game is to take so many of your opponent's seeds that they can no longer move. In order to take your opponent's seeds, two conditions must be met. First, they must have seeds in both of their holes, even if it is just one seed. If all of your opponent's seeds are at the back, they are safe. If they are all at the front, they are safe. There must be seeds in both holes for them to be vulnerable. Secondly, you must have at least one seed in your forward hole. So, providing that both of these terms are met, you have a chance at taking your opponent's seeds. All you have to do is to land in front of them, like this. If you land in a hole that you already occupy, and there are seeds in both of your opponent's holes, then you take all of their seeds. You start sowing again from the hole immediately after the hole that you began your last turn. This sounds complicated, but usually you just need to look for the last empty hole. Unless you've sown all the way around the board, the last empty hole is where you started from last time. Off you go again, sowing one seed at a time. Be careful that you only place one seed in each hole. It's easy when you're learning to accidentally let two seeds slip through, or to drop one in the wrong hole, or even to watch one bouncing off across the floor. The more you play, the better you'll get at keeping hold of your seeds. The last common rule that I'm going to throw in, just to spice things up, involves the last four holes on your left. So the last four holes on my left, and the last four holes on my opponent's left. So the rule here is that you can move backwards from any of these four holes, but only if you are absolutely certain that you can take on your first move. For example, here my opponent has four seeds. If they move backwards, they can definitely take my seeds. Once they have taken my seeds, they return to where they started, and from the next hole, they begin moving around the board in the normal direction. And by sheer luck, they can take again. there it is again from my side. I have 3 seeds. If I move backwards, I can definitely take. Then I return to where I started, and from the next hole, I start moving anti-clockwise again. Here is an example of an illegal move. My opponent has 2 seeds. They move backwards, but they cannot take, because I only have seeds in 1 hole, not both. So they would not be allowed to make that move. And that's really the basic rules of the game as I know them. You keep playing until your opponent cannot move anymore. Because remember, you cannot move a single seed from a hole, only multiple seeds. So like I said at the beginning, there are many variations of this game, and I'd love to know which rules you use.